How has crypto changed my life? Well, this was one of my most favorite topics. I'm a survivor from mental health and from those types of issues. I had a really rough upbringing. My dad passed away when I was 11 years old. I grew up very, very poor, and I experienced a lot of trauma growing up. That trauma stuck with me for a long time, and I always thought, you know, I wouldn't be able to get out of poverty. I wouldn't be able to improve my quality of life. I just had to deal with this 9-to-5 job working in healthcare, getting mistreated by the corporate office, getting mistreated by some of the clients, and just have this really shitty quality of life. But until I started changing my thought process, and that's when my life started to change in a positive aspect. And crypto was a really, really important part of that. I remember sitting in my car, waiting for the office to open, the medical office that I worked at. And I realized that the world around me didn't care about me. The only way that I was going to get able to get a better, improved quality of life was changes that I made. I kept hearing about Bitcoin on the radio.
What's going on, guys? Today, Bitcoin is claimed to be the gold of the
internet. So I decided to go ahead and take a plunge and invest, be a little bit risky. And that was kind of a really cool thing to do because I never thought in a million years that I was smart enough to teach myself to do anything. But actually working in healthcare kind of forced me to do that because in healthcare, you do have to learn basic dosage calculations, to learn to deal with and kind of coordinate, communicate with a lot of different people. So I took those skills that I learned from healthcare and I applied them to crypto, I applied them to trading, and it helped me become a pretty decent trader, which is cool. Never in a million years did I think I was gonna be some content creator. I don't like the way I look. I don't like to be on the internet. And getting shit online for just existing, it's not a fun feeling. For a long time, I was one of the few female voices in the space. So to consistently have people make up lies about you, say really terrible things about you, comment on the way you look, the way you talk, call you an idiot, isn't really a fun, welcoming thing. But at the same time, I've been able to create this really, really dope community in crypto with like-minded people, people who are interested in improving their quality of life, who are interested in advancing in the world. And that was all done with crypto. And I really think it had to do with a lot of the events that I hosted. I was able to network, to bring people together, to meet people. And at the end of the day, even though we're different when it comes to how we look, our cultures, that type of thing, at the same time, we're all in crypto to improve our quality of life for ourselves and our family. And I think that that's really powerful and really dope. And one of the things that I realize is people who are wealthy or people who are successful entrepreneurs, they take chances. All of those chances can be disastrous at times. But at the same time, if you do not take a chance, you're not going to know if you're going to be successful or not. And I think part of joining crypto was part of my journey in becoming successful and changing my life in a positive aspect. And I'm actually very, very grateful for Bitcoin and crypto because without it, I wouldn't have taken this chance and I wouldn't have learned what true entrepreneurship was.